Ever wonder why your energy bill is so high? The short answer is, only what you measure is manageable. Hi, Norbert here, energy engineer, and today explaining how you can monitor your home's global energy consumption and power usage in a simple way and affordable. If you look until the end of the video, you will have the exact affordable device and the knowledge to save hundreds on your energy bill and help to save the planet. So whereas you are about $200 euros per month, how can you get more overview and more control of what is about to disappear from your wallet? Another question is the dishwasher in this moment in its intensive power consuming phase? Or maybe I can also use my hair dryer in this moment. And last but not least, is there some way, some device which can help me to help save the planet and avoid all those disasters that the news media is talking about? But why bother about a new device? I have the main meter, isn't it? But it's not really user friendly. If I want to know something like power, so then I have to do this, and then I have also, well, oh, just forget it. I switched off everything, and now I can see by switching it on one after the other, what is going and which is which and where the consumption really is. So here, we start here. That's very little. This is the room where we are. So you see also the lighting of the room is going on, 24 watt. Okay. It was my wife, and she says the television in the bedroom is activated now. So there we go. So now we added the kitchen. The refrigerator is now switched on. And now I see that the big appliances in the kitchen are switched on. They are all in standby, so you don't see any important power here. But anyway, you see, you can just chase down where the consumptions are. And now I switch on the rest also. So that's the room here. And that's nothing. So now you will agree with me, with this power meter and also all the switches. You have really a high degree of transparency. You can chase down where the standby consumption is. A resolution on this power meter of 1/10 of a watt. And so even if you will find the standby power, and you can kill them by using, for example, this power strip appliances which have a standby consumption. You have them here in this way. And you just feel it. And of course, you can see that on that meter. If you are doing this, then of course, you will communicate it to the other people in the house. Take care that something important like the computer is going to be switched off.
How's it going, man?
What's also a very interesting application to save money is that you look into your contract. What are the expensive hours? And you just put a sticky note here on the cover when those hours are. So then you can see, okay, is it now an expensive hour? And what is the power meter? And is that justified? Or could I, for example, put a dishwasher more convenient hour? I'm not afraid of the dark.
Unbelievable!
Let's now talk about different methods to measure energy in your home. In this old video here, you see already this meter when it was still dismounted. And let's now compare that with the other two measurement methods which I regularly use. This Ketotec meter is a centimeter, so you just see all energy which is going into your home. So you have an overall view. But then on the individual level, you can use, for example, this meter. I use it also regularly. It's an individual meter, so you can use it to measure a refrigerator or a single machine. It's very simple. You have one display. You have many values on this display by just pushing the buttons. But it is very simple because you don't have to configure it. Then you have also these devices. They are smart plugs. They are very affordable because I bought three of these. One is now in use for the refrigerator. But I think it costs below 40 euros. And it is so affordable because you don't have a display. The display is your telephone. Typically, you would install this at a refrigerator or another device, maybe the computer. And then you configure it with the telephone, and then you leave it there. And after 1 month or so, after a week or some hours, you can see on the statistics what the consumption history was. So it gives a lot of information. So that are the examples and the advantages and the disadvantages of these three types of meters which I have in my home. You can find them in the description and you can purchase them, and then you can start energy monitoring at your home on a global level and also at the individual level. And man, something will change in your house and in your wallet also. And to help you with that, please look now after this video to the following video which I made months ago, and it was about 12 ways of saving energy at your home. You can see it here in this card. So let's now recap the main points. I showed you this very inexpensive meter at this moment with 25% off, so under 30 euros, and that is only a fraction of the bill which arrives every month at your home. Remember, only what you see, what you monitor, is manageable. You can spend this money in another way instead of throwing it away. And the plant will also be grateful to you. So I would really like to invite you to start energy monitoring and say in the comments what the results are. I thank you very much for watching, and I invite you also to like the video, to make a subscription with a notification so that you will always know when I come with a new video, which is always about energy, always to help you to save money, to save the planet, and to become more independent from the grid and from the infrastructures. I wish you good energy.